Imagine a flood of molten rock outpouring from a vent long ago within what is today the east coast of the United States. As lava erupted at a rate similar to the average flow of the Columbia River, it rapidly advanced from what is now Washington, D.C., before slowly going towards Annapolis. As the weeks progressed, the lava advanced further, eventually overrunning Wilmington and then flowing all the way to Philadelphia. This all occurred during a time span of only 49 days, by the end of which a massive 126-mile or 203-kilometer-long lava flow had been in place. However, while the lava flow I just described did actually erupt around 373,000 years ago, it did not in any way originate or erupt in the United States, but instead elsewhere on the planet. The reason I overlaid it in the eastern United States was so you, the audience, could understand how truly massive this lava flow was. Representing what is known as the Pampas Onduladas lava flow, it can be found in a remote and sparsely populated section of Argentina, where it is 350 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Concepcion. This largely unknown lava flow represents the single longest singular lava flow to erupt anywhere on Earth during the entirety of the last 5 million years. Yet, the origin of this voluminous lava flow also generates more questions. Not only did this eruption mysteriously begin a full 150 kilometers east of the chain of volcanoes which makes up the main Andes mountain range, but it occurred at a type of volcano which you simply don't find in the traditional Andes mountain range, a shield volcano. Additionally, there have been five other similarly voluminous lava flows in this unusual region which is known as the Payenia volcanic province in the last 4 million years, meaning more such unusually long-traveling lava flows may one day be produced again in the future. But first, why was the 1,938 square kilometer or 748 square mile Pampas Onduladas lava flow so long? This comes down to four factors. Low lava viscosity due to its composition, geologic setting, unusually high magma supply, and a uniform gentle slope of the terrain. It might come as a surprise that the lava which erupted in the world's longest quaternary period lava flow did not actually have the lowest possible viscosity common in the lava flow. Generally speaking, the more silicon dioxide a composition of lava has strongly correlates, and the more sodium and potassium a composition of lava has weakly correlates to an increase in viscosity. Thus, the Pampas Onduladas lava flow was produced by lava of a tracky basalt composition which has a fairly low viscosity. But why does this group of volcanoes exist about 100 miles east of the main volcanoes in the Andes mountain range? The answer relates to an odd bit of plate tectonics. As, while the Nazca Plate is subducting underneath the South American Plate, forming the main chain of volcanoes, a section of this subducting plate actually flattens out for a length of about 100 miles towards the east, not allowing significant melting to occur there. Yet, at the end of this length, the Nazca Plate steepens once again. In the last 4 million years, a section of this plate has suddenly snapped downwards at a much steeper angle, causing material in the mantle to rush upwards and fill the space where this plate once was. This sends large amounts of upwelling material into the crust, creating a large supply of molten rock. This molten rock has grown into a fairly large body of magma underneath the central eruptive center which marked the Payún-Matru shield volcano. Just like at Kilauea, but involving a larger supply of shallow magma, molten rock could rapidly be sent into the eastern rift zone, causing it to spill out at a high rate of up to several thousand cubic meters per second along a several kilometer long stretch of land, which would all effuse lava. This lava would then flow towards the east at a slow but steady rate, as for the next 200 kilometers, a steady downward slope of 0.33 degrees was present. Gravity would thus pull the lava downslope at a fairly constant speed. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's new patron, John the Rambling Scriblerian, for supporting this channel.